Hi everyone, welcome to this getting started tutorial about the view drop-down list of Synfusion. Imagine that you are about to answer a poll question that asks you to tell your favorite sports name. In this case, you would like to select a name from the list instead of manually typing in the values. Here comes the view drop-down list of Synfusion helps you to choose an item from a huge collection and display that selected item on the UI. Also, I can bind hierarchical data, do filtering, grouping, UI customization with templates, as well as can create a cascading drop-down list. Now, in this video, I will show you the steps to create a Vue project using the Vue CLI tool and will edit my code using the Visual Studio code. And finally, I can view the output result on any of the supported browsers. Okay. Let me open the Visual Studio code, and now to create a new Vue project, I may need to install the Vue CLI globally on my machine using the command npm install -g at vue/cli. As I have already installed it in my machine, so I'm skipping this step here. Now let me create a new Vue project using the command vue create drop-down list component. Here, I have named my project as drop-down list component. This will create an empty Vue application with no Synfusion packages. Now, I will navigate to the newly created application folder. Okay, now I have the empty Vue application, and to start using the drop-down list component within this application, I may need to install the drop-downs package using the command npm install at synfusion/ej2vue-dropdowns. This command will install the drop-down list plugin along with its dependencies. Once the installation gets completed, my application is ready to use the drop-down list component. The first thing I need to do here is to register the drop-down list plugin from Synfusion ej2vue-dropdowns package. For that, I will open the app.vue file and import the drop-down list plugin from Synfusion ej2vue-dropdowns package. And then, I also need to register the same plugin globally inside the API vue.use to register all child directives globally. Now, to start using the drop-down list, within the template section, I will define the EJS drop-down list tag inside the div element. Here, for better look, I have defined div element with CSS child. The next thing is, I need to define the CSS for drop-down list. So, inside the style section, let me import this component CSS in app.vue file. Okay, let me save the application and run my application with the command npm run save. This will start the development server and automatically reloads the page at any time whenever I make edits on my project. So here, you can see the drop-down list with no items. Now, to populate the records, I may need to bind the data source for the drop-down list component. For that, let me open the app.vue file, and within data function, I will define the object variable local data, an assigned array of objects, where each object is holding two fields, namely ID and game. For this data source, the appropriate data source field should be mapped to the fields property of the drop-down list component. So here, I need to define a variable local field and map this ID field to the value field and game to the text field. Now, let me assign this local data to the data source property of the drop-down list component. And I also assign this local field variable to the fields property. Here, this data source contains a list of sports name. So let me define the property placeholder with the value select a game, which will be displayed in drop-down list component as description. When you look at the drop-down list, you can see the sports name listed here. You can also notice that the drop-down list displays a short description as "Select a game." Here, by default, the pop-up width is 100% and pop-up height is 300 pixels, but you can also set custom height and width to it. To set custom height and width for the pop-up, I need to define pop-up width and pop-up height properties with custom values. So now, look at the drop-down list where the pop-up is displayed with custom height and width. Suppose if I want to bind remote data source to view drop-down list, then I may need to make use of Data Manager library of Synfusion. Here, the Data Manager acts as a gateway between the drop-down and data source and also uses queries to interact with both the local and remote data source. So, as a first step, I need to import the Data Manager and required adapter from Synfusion EJ2 data repository. Then, let me define the Data Manager with the properties like URL, adapter, and cross domain. In the URL, I will be using the already available remote URL service, which will retrieve the list of data through POST action and bind the resultant data to the view drop-down list. Also, I will set Web API adapter here as the URL is assigned with the existing Web API service. And cross domain option is set to true to allow the cross origin domain request. Now, within data function, I need to define a variable remote data and assign this data manager instance to it. Also, I need to map the data source fields, so let me define another variable remote fields. Here, I have used a remote data source which holds the following fields. Now, let me map this first name and employee ID to the text and value fields respectively. Okay, let me assign this remote data and remote fields to the data source and fields property of the drop-down list. Here, I have set employee names as data source, so let me change the placeholder property value as select a name. And now you can see the drop-down list which shows the employee names over here. This drop-down list displays the data items in the data source order. In case if I like to reorder these data items either in an ascending or descending order, then I may need to make use of the sort order property. Now, I'm going to sort these items in descending order. So, let me define the property sort order and set its value as descending. So here, the data items in the drop-down list are sorted in descending order like this. Okay, let me summarize some of the important points now. We have seen how to add the view drop-down list of Synfusion to the view application. Also, we have seen how to populate JSON data and remote data source to the drop-down list and how to sort the data source as well as how to set the custom height and width for the drop-down list pop-up. If you'd like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link which is shared in the description part below. If you find this video as useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel too. Thanks for watching this video.